Jacqueline Cochran, 1910 to 1980. Jacqueline Cochran was born in Florida in 1910 and orphaned soon after. She grew up with a poor family and had very little formal education, but was gifted with a drive to succeed. In her teen and later years, she aggressively pursued a career in cosmetics and went to the top of her profession as the owner of a prestigious salon and a developer of a line of cosmetics. Her husband-to-be, millionaire businessman Floyd Odlum, suggested that she learn to fly in order to be more effective in her use of sales time and travel. She agreed, and who could know how it would change her life? Cochran mastered flying in a few weeks and soon owned her first airplane, a Travelair, later graduating to a Northrop Gamma. She became deeply committed to flying, yet she found a way to keep her cosmetics business going all through the war and into the 1950s. Cochran became a test pilot and world-renowned aviatrix. Among her early accomplishments, she tested the first turbo supercharger ever installed on an aircraft engine in 1934. Her taste for record setting was keen. She was the first woman to fly a bomber across the Atlantic Ocean. She held racing titles, including first in women's division of the Bendix cross-country event, and third place against a field of men pilots. Jackie Cochran was clearly a bright and determined woman. While pursuing her flying passion, Cochran saw a way to promote her idea that women pilots could ferry new military airplanes from factories to air bases, freeing male pilots for other duties. She discussed it with Eleanor Roosevelt in 1939 and found her very accepting, as Eleanor always promoted the advancement of women. Sometime later, she approached General Hap Arnold with her idea. General Arnold thought it had possibilities, but wasn't convinced. So Jackie gathered information about women licensed pilots along with their flying hours. Getting little support for her plan from the U.S. Air Force, but a warmer reception from the Royal Air Force, she traveled to England to help the RAF set up a women pilots group for ferrying military aircraft. Upon returning to the U.S., she found that Nancy Love had been approved to set up a similar plan using 28 experienced commercial-level female pilots, named Women's Auxiliary Ferrying Squadron. Jackie went to Arnold demanding an explanation and again arguing her broader plan, finally coming away with her own approved program in September 1942, named Women's Flying Training Detachment. In August 1943, the WAFS and the WFTD were merged and renamed Women Air Force Service Pilots, WASP. Cochran was named Director of Women Pilots, AAF, and Nancy Love became Executive Director on the ATC Ferrying Division staff. By early 1944, air superiority had been achieved in Europe and American pilots began to come home to few piloting jobs. It was apparent that the WASP program was nearing its end as well. Cochran's women pilots had made their mark and acquitted themselves well. Jackie had one final desire. She wanted the WASP to be militarized in order to discharge them with military veteran status, and for this she saw no compromise. She compiled an exhaustive report detailing the WASP accomplishments and released it to the press. Cochran insisted that General Arnold find a way to militarize her program, including pilot training under her command. Her wish was not to be fulfilled just then. General Arnold deactivated WASP December 20, 1944, acknowledging the women had exceeded all expectations, but refusing to broach the idea of military status. Jackie Cochran remained at the Pentagon as a special consultant to General Hap Arnold and was awarded the Distinguished Service Medal for her wartime service. In 1948, she finally received her military commission, Lieutenant Colonel in the U.S. Air Force Reserves. Continuing to establish new speed records, she became the first woman to break the sound barrier in 1953. Jacqueline Cochran died in 1980 at her ranch in Indio, California. In 1996, the United States Postal Service honored Jacqueline Cochran with an airmail postage stamp.